Hello everyone, how are you? I trust all of you are absolutely fit and fine at your home. My name is Shavanjali and I'm back with another story. The story today is The Caterpillar's Voice. The Caterpillar's Voice. It's a folk tale. Now, Caterpillar's Voice. Sounds interesting, doesn't it? Do you know caterpillar is a very tiny, it's a very tiny insect. It's a very tiny insect. Voice. I don't think an insect that tiny can have a very powerful voice. Well, but the story is telling us about something very interesting about his voice. So, let us all see what this story is all about. Okay? I hope you enjoy this story. Let's start. Once upon a time, a caterpillar crawled inside a hare's house when the hare was away. He started making himself comfortable. Ah, this is so relaxing. This is so comfortable. I like it here. This is fun. And the caterpillar started enjoying. And he forgot the hare must be returning home soon. The hare returned home. He noticed new marks on the ground going into the cave. He called, "Who's in my house?" The caterpillar boomed in a loud voice. "It is I, yes, I, who crushes rhinos to the earth and tramples elephants into dust." The hare hopped about crying. "What can I do with a small animal like me to a creature who crushes rhinos and tramples elephants? What am I going to do? I'm so small." So the hare soon met a jackal. He asked the jackal to talk to the terrible creature who had taken possession of his home and convince him to leave. The jackal agreed, and when he reached the place, when he reached the hare's house, the jackal said in a loud voice, he barked, "Who's in the house of my friend the hare?" The caterpillar replied in a voice that rocked the earth, "It is I, yes, I, who crushes rhinos to the earth and tramples elephants into dust." On hearing this, the jackal thought, "Certainly, I can do nothing against such a creature." And he quickly left. Then what happened? The hare fetched for other people who could help him. So he ran into the tiger. And he begged the tiger to help him. The tiger assured the hare it would be no trouble at all. On reaching the spot, the tiger bared his claws and growled, "Who's in the house of my friend the hare?" The caterpillar replied in the same manner as he has done before. The tiger was alarmed and thought, "If he crushes rhinos and elephants, I don't even want to think about what he could do to me." So the tiger also ran to save his life. Next, the hare tried to look for more help. He said, "I need to look for somebody else who can help me." So who did he find? He found a rhinoceros. So he said, "Will you help me?" The rhinoceros said, "Yes, of course. I am the most fearsome of beasts. So the caterpillar, so whoever is in your house will be scared of me." So the hare agreed, "Yes, you are a big animal. You can scare off the intruder." So he said, "Will you come with me now?" He said, "Yes, let's go." So the rhino marched into the hare's cave. He snorted and pawed the ground with his massive feet. But when the rhino asked who was inside inside and heard caterpillar's booming reply, he thought, "What? He says he can crush me to the earth?" And the rhino thundered away, crashing through the forest. Growing frantic, the hare said, "I must ask someone else for help now. This is not helping me. None of the animals were able to help me. What should I do?" So he saw an elephant at a distance. He said, "Oh, let me ask this elephant to help me." So the elephant came to him. He said, "Yes, are you looking for me?" He said, "Yes, I need your help. There's an intruder in my house. Somebody broke into my house." And that person and that animal says that they crush rhinos and elephants. "I'm so scared. Will you be able to help me?" He said, "Who can crush a rhino and me? I'm an elephant. I'm a big animal. I ought to see who this is. I ought to see who's causing the nuisance. Come, let's go to your house." But like the others, on hearing what the caterpillar had to say, the elephant knew that he had no wish to be trampled underfoot like dust. He had no wish to be trampled under someone's feet, and that too into dust. So he said, no, I'm not going to be here. I'm going to go." He also got scared and ran away. Next, the caterpillar was so disappointed as nobody was, the hare was so disappointed as nobody was able to help him. He said, "What shall I do?" So next, he saw a frog. So he said, so the frog asked the hare, "You look very sad. You look very disappointed. Is everything all right?" He said, so the hare explained everything to the frog. And he said, "You know, an intruder has barged into my house without asking me while I was away. Do you think that's a fair thing to do?" The frog said, "Certainly not. That's not a nice thing for anyone to do. How can someone enter your house like that?" So the hare said, "Well, none of the animals could help me. None of the animals, big or small. I don't know what to do." So the frog said, "Well, I am a small animal. I don't know if I'll be of much help to you, but obviously it's worth a try." So the hare said, "Yes," but the hare was so disappointed, and he also was very desperate to go to his house. So he said, "Yes, you should also try. What if you're able to do something about the situation?" "Of course, you're my friend. I shall help you." So the frog then reached the hare's house. The frog went to the cave door and asked who was inside. He received the same reply as had been given to the others. Then the frog went nearer and shouted, "I, who am the strongest of all, have come at last. I am the one who crushes those who crushes the rhinos. I am the one who tramples underfoot those who trample the elephants." So the caterpillar heard this. He got very scared, and the caterpillar started trembling with fear. He sensed the shadow of the frog coming nearer and nearer, and he thought, "After all, I'm only a caterpillar." And the caterpillar inched out of the hare's den along its edge, trying not to be noticed. So he went slowly, so nobody notices him. But what happened? All the animals who had collected near the hare's house, they all were standing there because they all wanted to see who this animal is. Who is the intruder? They all were collected outside the house to see who the intruder is. So all the animals seized the caterpillar. They seized the caterpillar and dragged him out. "What? You? They all cried in disbelief. Then what did the caterpillar said? He said, well, this is the time to play it smart. He said, I would never dream of staying in that cave, said the caterpillar with his nose in the air. And then the caterpillar thought, yes, this is the right way to save my life. Otherwise, they'll all eat me up. So he said, an echo like that is far too crude for a refined creature like me. As he sniffed away, all the other animals laughed at the trouble he had given him. Such a small animal fooled us. So, my dear children, so, do you know what is the moral of the story? Well, the moral of the story is that you should always first judge a situation. See for yourself. If there is some problem that you feel has arisen, first judge it yourself. See it for yourself. You should never make a hue and cry about something that you have not experienced or seen on your own. All right? I am going to see you very soon. I hope you all enjoyed this session today. And let's meet on next Saturday for another fun story. Take care of yourself. Be good, be safe, be happy. Bye.